I'm like, what is going on? Why are we talking about this right now?
I've got to get out of here. I've got to get out of here.
Calm down. Get a hold of yourself.
All right, welcome to the show, Not Exactly Experts. We're back for another episode. Again, as always, thank you all for listening. Thank you for tuning in. We really appreciate it. Hopefully, there's some enjoyment of what you guys are going to get out of today's topic of airplanes and reclining a seat back. But before we get to that, we had a poll on the Chiefs. Rusty, run us through that.
Yeah, we sure did. We talked about Jarrett's favorite quarterback, Patrick Mahomes. And I know he wants to continue talking about it, but our poll was, is Patty Mahomes the best quarterback in the NFL right now? And overwhelmingly, the majority of people said yes. 76% that voted said he is.
That's just a lot of people. That just shows me a lot of people don't watch the NFL.
And, oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
Yeah, the 24% don't.
I had to think of a quarterback who carried a team and who was obviously a very undervalued quarterback. So I picked Russell Wilson. And I am not a Seahawks fan by any means, but I have been getting so much grub from these two about my love for Russell Wilson. I just picked a guy. I had to think of somebody who I thought was undervalued. And these two just have railed me over Russell Wilson.
And I guess three fourths of our listeners have our side too. Onward.
Onward. We're done talking about this. We're never talking football again.
So on to this episode's topic. In the headlines recently, that's been kind of blowing up and trending virally, is this passenger on an American Airlines flight who posted a video from her phone of the guy behind her repeatedly just punching the back of her seat because she was reclined.
Like Evander Holyfield.
He wasn't punching. So it was more or less pushing hard.
The topic is reclining. Like, first off, let's chat about this specific situation, and then let's get into like the actual fact of reclining. My take is the guy was completely out of line, first off, of punching the seat. Like, why would he even be doing that? Like, it's completely unnecessary.
Now, you have to tell the whole story. Again, she's really the only one that's come out and talked about it. But the story is the guy asked her to stop. Not nicely. He wasn't polite about it. He was kind of rude and said, hey, I need room. I need to be able to put my thing down and actually eat my food. You know, can you put your chair back up? And she didn't want to, but she did. And then as soon as he was done with his food, she put it back. And he asked her to put it back, and she wouldn't. So he started hitting. And she says he hit really hard before she started taking the video.
So you're telling me she complied with his request, and then
he asked her to not do it. He was trying to be semi-polite and just say it was because of his lunch, hoping she would get the picture.
This is where I think it's lost of what really happened. Of course, she's going to say that he was rude, but then that doesn't give you an excuse to then for you to act childish and still stay reclined. And then the video just shows him with his fist up against her chair, and he's just kind of moving it. That's all he is. Okay. Like you couldn't hit a punching bag for it to move the way he was just kind of moving it up and down.
Yeah. But it was enough that that's like, just like an absolute annoyance, like to her.
The same thing with her reclining.
But the thing is, seat reclines. Like,
that doesn't mean that you can recline. Do it. Dude, I can fart.
Then why do they recline?
Does that mean I can fart on people and it's fine?
But you're not farting for 4 hours on a flight constantly.
Exactly.
I've been on flights where I feel like the guy next to me was farting for 4 hours.
Look, the thing is, it's gotten absolutely worse because she plans to sue. She plans to sue American Airlines with legal action over the rep that said she also spilled her drink.
So a part of this is to kind of add to the rest of the story, she spoke up to the flight attendant and, you know, mentioned like, hey, right, this guy behind me is bothering me. And apparently the response that she got from the flight attendant was an eye roll. And the flight attendant was just annoyed and actually handed the gal a piece of paper that essentially says, you might be in violation with FAA regulations. You best not speak up anymore or say anything, right? Or you know, basically threatening to kick her off the flight, which blows my mind. Like, how is that possible?
Did she take a picture of this note?
I've not I've not seen the picture.
Oh, she did?
You can find it on some of the articles. I mean, it wasn't like a note that the lady just went and wrote. It's something that they have typed up that I'm pretty sure the rules pretty much state that if a flight attendant asks you to do something, you have to comply with them. And regardless, I think, of whether you like what they ask you to do, and that's what the lady was saying was, hey, this guy doesn't have any space back here. That's why he's upset, is because you're reclining into his seat. You know, he's asking you to put your seat back up. And she got mad and said, no, I'm not going to do it.
Look, this whole situation, once in with the airplane, started because she leaned back. He asked her if it was, even if it was rude, to put your seat back up. And she didn't. She just wanted to also now be the child game. So now you have these two little kids, aka adults, bumping heads, and this whole situation now has blown up because both of these people just could not be adults about this whole situation, just suck it up for 2 or 3 hours that were in the air and just move on with your lives. It's ridiculous.
It's a personal space thing, though. Like, that's what I don't get, is like, the rules are different on an airplane. Like, if it was anything else in a public setting, if I reclined into your lap, well, that would not be okay. It would not be okay in any other setting.
But dude, airplanes recline, what, like 3 inches? I don't see what the big deal is. And it's not like this thing went clear down into the dude's lap. I've flown dozens of times, and I've had the person in front of me recline. I think nothing of it because, one, dude, there's so little freaking space on an airplane. Like,
to
it
begin
already
with.
Sucks that it is. Yeah, it already sucks as it is. So
why make it worse?
It's not like when someone's reclining, it's going into my knees or like it's hitting my chest.
It can.
It's not. No.
But it wasn't.
No.
Yeah, dude.
No. No. It reclines from up above. It's not like she's scooting the seat backwards, like where your knees are. Like,
a lot
it's
of times
ridiculous.
On airplanes, my knees are already hitting their seat. I don't fit in them to begin with. If you're a big guy, you're uncomfortable to begin with, and you just make it worse. It's like I said, it's a personal space issue. You might not think they're in your lap, but it's what it makes you feel like.
The more I think about it, I'm leaning towards fur right now.
Yes.
Because the seats, like you said, they recline from straight up and down to maybe 3 inches. And that's
kind of straight up and down.
Yeah, kind of.
I mean, it's not that much at all. And the other thing, when you board a plane, you know, right, that seats recline. So you should expect, right, that the person in front of you may be reclining. Deal with it. If you don't like it, don't fly.
Everybody knows that air travel sucks. It's terrible. It's some of the worst experiences that some people will ever go through, just because of where you have to go to pick up your luggage, and then how airplanes they're smaller. And obviously all of us are pretty tall guys, pretty big, we're big guys. So we know we're not going to have any room on a plane whatsoever. And maybe I bet this guy has dealt with it all the time. Just somebody constantly reclining.
It's just a move. If you ask me, it's a move because
the lady
you
has
just said,
a fused
okay, they're going
spine
back
in her neck.
Oh my
god.
Let
gosh. The lady recline.
Don't get on the airplane, fur. Don't get on the airplane. If you got an unfused spine, maybe you shouldn't be freaking flying.
Do you think that he could accommodate her just a little bit? Like, I really don't feel bad that he couldn't put his whole foot-long Subway sandwich in the right angle in front of him. Like, seriously? Like, someone reclining in front of you preventing you from eating? I don't think so.
The extra 3 inches really made a difference. And first of all, when she is reclining, he can't put the tray down.
Yes, you can.
You can't.
You can't.
Yes.
Dude, it was in the article. That was the reason why he was mad, was because he couldn't put the tray down.
How can the tray not go down? Plus, what do you want the tray down for anyway? It's the grossest thing. Who in God's country wants to put food on that freaking gross-ass tray?
I have to agree. Yeah. And that tray doesn't hold anything. That tray,
That tray is a petri dish of bacteria. It's a petri dish of bacteria. You do not want to put your food on that anyway.
They don't
First
clean
of
those
all,
trees.
All I'm hearing is it's okay to be an That's all I'm hearing.
It's okay.
Everybody's going to hate it. On both
getting
sides.
Getting on an airplane already sucks. Let's just make it worse. What? So we can't just treat people with decency?
Well, what
personal space we
have
thing.
How come we have to recline
personal
it?
Personal space. You've already given up your personal space when you get on a plane, right?
Yeah, so let's make it worse. You're making it worse.
3 inches?
The CEO of Delta has spoken up.
Oh, okay.
Would you assume that CEO of Delta would know what he's talking about?
What did he or she say?
I would love to hear.
He said that reclining in an airplane is kind of an cool move.
Well, then the plane should make the seats so they don't recline. This is an airline industry problem then.
That's a very solid argument.
If you're coming out and saying that they shouldn't recline, then it's your own darn fault. Make them so they don't recline. Then we don't have this problem at all. But guess what? They recline. So we're going to use it.
So we're just going to use all the things in this world that suck just because they made them?
No.
Hey, every single person that I see that's taking a nap now, I'm going to buy a freaking air horn. I'm going to blow it right in their ear and just say, well, they make them. I'm sorry.
Let me know how that works for you.
Exactly.
I recommend you not
be punched, and I'm probably going to get on social media, and I'm going to be seen as a
You're going to prison.
Go for it.
You don't go to prison for reclining. You go to prison for blowing an air horn on a plane. I'm guessing that's an FAA offense.
I didn't say on a plane.
Yeah,
but said in general.
We're talking on a plane here.
That's what I'm saying. Why has everything changed because we're on an airplane?
But you know why you don't get an air horn and blow it in someone's ear?
If somebody asks me to not do something, I'm going to not do it.
Right.
I don't care.
Now, let's just say,
said it. I get on the airplane knowing that my comfort's going to suck. You know what? The reclining 3 inches really makes it that much better.
Did her reclining back make him less comfortable? Like, did it change the position he was in? Did it hit his body? Could he not flail his arms like he wants to? Like, it didn't affect his seat. He's in the last freaking row, which he chose because he was on an airline that you pick your seat or that you choose before. It's not like first come, first serve. So he's in the last row. He knows he can't recline. That was his decision to be there.
Again, argument I hear is it's okay to be a jerk. Just because they make it, it's okay. They're going to use it.
You're just perceiving that reclining is being a jerk act.
If somebody asks you not to do it because it makes them uncomfortable, yes, you're being a jerk. You are.
He asked to do it while he was eating. He finished eating and then she reclined back.
And he asked her not to do it.
And you're defending the person who was punching the back of her seat repeatedly over and over.
I'm not going to defend how he did it. I'm going to defend that you should not recline an airplane.
I don't think reclining is a big deal. I don't think it's a big deal.
Okay, you flip-flopper. When we started this show, you said it was.
He knows where it's at.
God, yeah. Pick a side.
Hey,
all right, so our sides have chosen. We want to hear from our listeners and viewers of like, can you recline? Can you not recline? Is it okay? Is it not okay? Let's talk about a few other things that are related to an airplane, right? So we are obviously very sided when it comes to reclining or not. What about the middle seat? Okay, so the middle seat, notoriously, nobody wants to be in it, right? You're crunched in between two people. Inevitably, they're two big men, typically, just for whatever reason, how it always works out. Do you have the rights to the armrests because of the uncomfortable position that you're in when you're in the middle seat?
First of all, if you're scrunched between two bigger guys, you're not even going to get a chance to put your arm anywhere.
You know what would be nice, Rusty? If those two bigger guys both reclined and gave you shoulder space. Or maybe if you could recline and get a little shoulder space. But your team no recline, so never mind. You can't do that.
Yeah, I wouldn't sacrifice. I wouldn't sacrifice my own comfort for all the other people behind me. So F that. I would never recline. Never. Ever.
So middle seat, armrest. Do you get both armrests? Is that like unwritten code, like common courtesy? Or are you just up a creek? Like you get nothing. You get no shoulder space. You get no reclining if you're near Rusty, and you get no armrests.
I think if you're the middle seat and then all of a sudden you just claim just both armrests like that, I mean, number one, that's a big move. I mean, that's a bold move.
It's a big move, but if you're on the edges, you get space on toward the window. You can kind of lean toward the window, and if you're in the middle, you've got that inside armrest that's yours, and you can always kind of lean in toward the middle and have space. So, I think if you're in the middle, you get both armrests.
I think it's first come, first serve. I think you have to, when you sit down, you have to claim it. And so when a person comes across and they have to sit on the window seat, that your arm is locked. It's like, I got this. I was here, man.
What if armrests recline, Rusty? Could you recline an armrest?
No.
So moving on. Which is better, a window seat or an aisle seat?
Aisle.
Window. Ooh, aisle and window.
Yeah.
Window. Tell me why a window, and I'll tell you all the reasons why you're an idiot.
You can see outside.
Oh my goodness. I can look on Google and find a picture of what it looks like outside of an airplane. Yeah, do it your first time. The first time you go to Vegas, sit on the window seat, see it. It's beautiful. Oh my gosh. You know what sucks about being in the window seat? Anytime that you think you got to use the restroom, now you got to make two people get up out of their freaking seat, take their buckle off.
That's why you go before your flight. That's called pre-planning.
Well, the majority of people don't do that.
Well, I thought we were just asking our general opinions. And so my general opinion is the one where I can see the clouds and the birds. And what's better, Rusty, seeing Bigfoot on Google or seeing Bigfoot in real life?
You don't see him at all because he doesn't exist.
No.
Like seeing Russell Wilson as an MVP. Just doesn't happen.
Okay, moving on. What would it take for you to step up and do something on an airplane? So let's start with this scenario. Let's say you're next to these two who you see bickering right back and forth. Do either of you step up and just be like, hey, you two, like, come on. Like, this is silly. Chill. No. Jared says no.
No, I'm very passive. If I see this whole thing, I just...
Like... Rusty starts punching the lady as well. He joins in.
Yeah.
No. I never said I would punch.
First, for reclining.
I will tell you this. If somebody reclines in front of me, like into me, I don't ever say anything. That's just not my personality. I'm mad. I'm irritated because it's in my way. I don't like it. But anyways, I don't think I would say anything unless it was escalating to the point where it was like upsetting my family or something like that.
Yes. So it has to be if they're upsetting my family, or if it's some like drunk guy on a plane and he's saying stuff to me. Like if that happens.
7A.
So I'm in seat 7A. So is that Dirk Bentley song?
You got it. Impressive.
There you go. There you go.
Very nice.
Because I couldn't think. Is this like, well, does he mention 7A? I don't remember. But anyway, so like if he starts badgering me about something, chances are it's probably because I'm wearing a Cowboys shirt. Like I'm going to do something.
When he starts talking bad about Russell Wilson, Jarrett's done.
I'm not a Seahawks fan, okay?
Rusty, what happens if you're on a plane and Patrick Mahomes reclines in front of you?
What if Patrick Mahomes and his girlfriend and his TikTok famous brother, what if they all recline? What if they all recline right in front of you? You would be like, oh, this is the best day ever. That's what you would
do. His hair.
Yeah, you wouldn't say, you would love it. You're like, this is the best day ever. And then Jackson Mahomes would ask you to be in TikTok.
Heck yes. Okay, so this is how I'm going to end it. I made a list of other things that I think are total moves.
Okay.
One, talking on a speakerphone in public. Everybody hates it.
I don't mind that. I think it's kind of fun to listen in on someone else's conversation.
I've heard women say they hate it when people order fajitas for lunch because they have to smell it in their hair for the rest of the day.
Fajitas are so good. No, I can't agree with that.
Everybody has to smell it then. Maybe you don't like fajitas. Well,
get it for your friends and, okay, and we're going on coworkers.
Sitting right next to someone at a movie theater with other spots open. Like, there's tons of other seats. Somebody comes and sits right next to you.
What if someone reclines in front of you? What if someone reclines in front of you?
There's plenty of room. There's plenty of room. It's fine.
That's a creepy move. That's a bold, creepy move.
It's almost as creepy as, like, being in a public restroom for guys at urinals, and there's three of them, and you're in the far left, and the guy comes to the one in the middle.
Yeah.
Dude, no.
Move down. Go use the toilet.
Yeah. Why do you need to be close to me?
Go sit down. Anyway. Go sit down when you pee.
Maybe you like to pee in company.
A couple more here. So parking so close to another vehicle that they can't open their door.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Driving really close behind someone without passing them, like on the highway.
Oh, I can't stand that. Love Everybody to give people it. A brake check.
Yes.
I've gotten many a bird from that.
I recently never received the bird till I moved out here. I've been flipped off three times since I moved out here. One was my fault.
They passed you and you're like, you're right. Thank you.
If you're leaving a tip for a waitress and all you leave is change, unless it's like a lot of money, but if you're leaving like...
Money in coinage?
If they're dollar coins?
That would be okay. That's at least enough money. But if your bill's $13 and you put down $13.67, you put down $14 and that's all you leave...
Agree.
You're not serving Mario and Luigi. Hey, if you're going to serve in tips, you're going to be serving dollar bills. You probably have more than coins in your pocket.
You should. Couple more. Okay. Breaking up with someone over text.
Yes, it is.
I've stopped doing that.
My last one is being a no-show. Whether you had an interview, an appointment, a date, not showing up or not saying anything.
Yeah, ghosting.
Which is, happens a lot these days. It's pretty weird, but it's just anyways.
Is this easier not to show up instead of just saying, "Hey, not gonna make it, not gonna make the interview, not gonna take the job."
All respect lost.
Very much.
Oh yeah.
So.
Oh yeah.
And to me, reclining on an airplane's the worst.
No, it's the worst
of all of them.
No way.
I hate it.
Can't be the worst.
I hate it.
All right. For this week's Neek of the Week, then. I think it goes to the two of these individuals involved in this situation. Obviously, it could have been handled much better. If you haven't seen the video, we will post it on our social media. Check it out. They are not exactly experts. Clip of the week. Thank you all for tuning in. That is a wrap for this go-around. As always, we appreciate you all for listening and watching us. Until next time, not exactly experts. Sign it out. We'll see you later. Fine drinks for everybody, but the pilot, it's a party.